I'm Amara.
I'm Molly.
I'm Emma.
And I'm Hannah.
And we're the Green Gap Girls from Mid Farm. For our project, we have chosen future-proof designing buildings for climate change. And for us, this includes being able to withstand anything that climate change brings and should be able to prevent climate change as much as possible by using eco-friendly materials, energy sources and ways of living. We have chosen to set up a hostel on the side of Conakill, and this will hold displaced people who have been homeless before ice caps melting. And this means their situation has escalated during floods from the melting in the future.
A bit about our location. Conakill is a 153-metre hill in prominence and is 361 metres above sea level. This is plenty of space for us to build our hostel without the rising sea levels meeting us, as they would rise 70 metres if all the ice caps were to melt.
It's steep at first, but it gradually eases out, so it is an easy climb for most people. It also has easy access. On top of this, it is pretty viewed for less unfortunate people who just need to go and relax. It levels out, so it is good to build on, and it isn't desolate from any civilization.
When it comes to waste, we are going to try to reduce it as much as possible. We will build compost patches somewhere around our perimeter and put all our food waste in there. We will also be using non-chemical fertilisers instead of the chemical ones that pollute our planet, so we don't ruin it anymore.
Having a compost patch is beneficial because it means we will be using less plastic than if we were to use a compost bin. We will also be following the waste hierarchy, which ranks waste management according to what is best for the environment. The list is as follows. Reducing waste is the most important, and then reusing if possible. After that is recycling, recovering and replacing. Remaking and disposing are the least beneficial.
For our food source, we will be having a vegetable patch near the house. The best vegetables to grow are onions, spring onions and spinach, as we can grow them all year round. We will also be farming things like chicken and lamb for protein, as well as bringing some tinned fruit and veg along.
Our energy will come from solar panels and wind turbines. The solar panels will be sitting on top of the roof with enough power to keep the structure going. Wind will also let the house spin around steadily, so each house gets enough sunlight.
The shape of the model acts as a turbine on a bearing. The energy is stored in the batteries, which are held in the legs.
When researching materials, we were determined that we needed to think about what effect they had on the environment. Cross-laminated timber stood out to us, so we've decided to use this for a lot of the main structure of the building.
Cross-laminated timber is made up of layers of glued timber stuck in certain ways to make it rigid. It is also naturally fire resistant as it chars, and if it's exposed to fire, a layer of protective char would be formed, and then this would insulate the remaining CLT section, reducing oxygen and heat from entering the outside.
Okay. Our model was also made using eco-friendly materials. Most of the model has been constructed with double-sided tape so it can be taken apart and recycled. Some of the materials we used were recycled aluminium mesh, recycled high-impact polystyrene, and balsa wood. Balsa wood is also eco-friendly, as for every tree that is cut down, two are planted.
These are the key features of our house. We have thought them through more in the report, and there's logic and meaning behind everything. We have based all of our ideas on how to help climate change and how to help the earth. We really hope you agree with all our ideas, and thank you for listening.
Thank you for the opportunity.
And thanks for the opportunity.
Bye. Bye. It's the end of the world.